Have you heard of a humble jazz player named Walter Theodore Sonny Rollins? To most people, he is simply known as Sonny Rollins. Sonny Rollins grew up in Harlem and was born on September 7, 1930. He picked up playing the alto saxophone at age 14 and then switched to tenor saxophone 2 years later. When Sonny was growing up, it was the start of World War II. This was also a period when African Americans were fighting for equality and their own freedoms. At that time, music was one of the ways for him and other African Americans to express their feelings and was also an important mode of creative communication. One of the hard struggles Sonny Rollins faced was not being able to play any time he wanted because of everyone's complaints that he was too noisy. But that changed when he found somewhere he could play freely, the Williamsburg Bridge, where he would practice day and night for up to 16 hours every season, including winter. That shows how dedicated he was to playing his music. Sonny faced other very hard things, just like, too, like struggling with drug addiction and going to jail for 10 months at Rikers Island Prison for robbery. The most surprising thing to me is that he was able to change his path by sharing his love of playing the saxophone with the whole world. He went from making those gigantic mistakes when he was younger to receiving a Medal of the Arts from President Barack Obama in a big White House ceremony when he was an adult. During his music career, he also won 3 Grammys. Focusing on music really changed his life. Sonny once said, "When I play, what I try to do is to reach my subconscious level. I don't want to overly think about anything, because you can't think and play at the same time. Believe me, I've tried it." After many tracks and a few recording sessions, he made his first album called The Bridge in 1962. Sonny Rollins is among the finest improvisers on a tenor saxophone to appear since the mid-1950s. And guess what? He's still alive. In Washington, D.C., I had the opportunity to visit the National Museum of African American History and Culture in the Music Hall and learned about his important contributions to African American culture and also found this picture of him along with his saxophone. I found his name listed amongst the most important African American artists of his era. If you are interested in learning more about this amazing saxophonist, there's a book you can find in the J.S. Library called Sonny's Bridge. Sonny's Bridge is a book with beautiful illustrations by the illustrator Keith Mallett and a wonderful story by the author Barry Wittenstein. Now stop listening to this book trailer and go and find Sonny's Bridge in our J.S. Library.